We're going to test this new 16-inch MacBook Pro with M4 Pro CPU today, and we will see how it compares to my old laptop, which is also 16-inch MacBook Pro, but with M1 Pro CPU. We will test the processor, the graphics, the SSD drive, battery, anything you might be interested in. I guess many of you might be in exactly the same situation like me. You maybe have a few years old MacBook based on M1 or M1 Pro processor, and you are wondering right now if it would be worth to upgrade after those 3 years or so. I hope this test will help you make that decision, so let's get started. Left half of the page will be dedicated for M4 Pro processor, and the right side is for older M1 Pro results from my older laptop. And I started with Geekbench 6, because this is the most popular test run on macOS, I believe. And we've got the results. For single core, for M1 Pro, we've got 2427, and for M4 Pro, we've got 3975. That means single core performance of M4 Pro is 63% higher than M1. And for multi-core, we've got 12612 for M1, and 22,870 for M4 Pro. And this means the M4 is 81% faster. And that doesn't make sense, because it also has 14 cores, not 10. So multi-core advantage is even higher. This is Geekbench 6 again, but this time it's GPU test for OpenCL type of API. And the results: 41,920 for M1 Pro and 70,041 for M4 Pro. This means M4 Pro's score is 67% higher. Now we've got Geekbench 6.0 again, but this time for GPU API type Metal. I believe this is more popular than the previous one, and the results are 68,390 for M1 Pro and 115,048 for M4 Pro. So here in this test, M4 Pro is faster by 68% than M1 Pro. And I just wanted to note again, we'll also have more GPU cores, because it has 20 GPU cores, whereas M1 Pro has 16 cores. Quite significant difference. Now we've got Cinebench, and first test is for GPU. And in this first test, M1 Pro scores 2615 points, and M4 Pro scores 8397. Just have a look again, the difference is massive here. I don't know exactly what this test does in the background, to be honest, why this GPU test is so much higher than in Geekbench, but anyways, that would mean the M4 Pro is 221% faster than M1 Pro, the GPU I mean. Now the Cinebench again. By the way, this is 2024 version, yes, of Cinebench. And the scores for CPU multi-core, we've got 822 points for M1 Pro, and 1742 for M4 Pro. That means the M4 Pro has 112% higher score than M1 Pro. And the last Cinebench test is for CPU, but this time for single core. And M1 Pro, as we can see, scores nearly exactly the same as M1 or M1 Ultra and M1 Max, which makes sense because it's the same family. But M4 Pro scores 175 points, which means it has 56% faster single core than M1 Pro. Now we've got Blender tests, and I used Blender dedicated benchmark software. This software has three tests. They are called Monster, Junk Shop, and Classroom. And the difference between M1 Pro and M4 Pro is quite significant. In every single test, M4 Pro scores nearly 100% more points than M1 Pro. So for Classroom, for example, 43 points M1 Pro and 85 for M4 Pro. This is 97% faster. And other tests look similar. 64 to 118 and 98 to 195. This is also close to 100% higher score. These are results for SSD drives, and both of those laptops have the same disk sizes, 512 GB. And 512 GB is the starting point for 16-inch M4 Pro anyways. I believe for M1 Pro it was an upgrade from 256. But let's have a look at the results. We can see they are both great. I mean, the M1 Pro is a little bit strange. I don't understand why the write speed is higher than read, but never mind. Doesn't really matter. They are both super fast SSDs we can see 5 gigabytes per second for both reads and writes. They're both great. I mean, for me, the M1 Pro SSD is even more impressive because it's like 3 years old laptop, but it still keeps up fine, you know? 5 gigabytes per second, it's a great result even today. Alright, but let's have a look at another test. And this is GFX Bench Metal, and it has a lot of built-in test engines. It can test CPUs, GPUs, you can see some of them are kind of like similar to 3D Mark. Some of them I have no idea what it does, like these green things that you could see. But I just run them all, which takes quite a while, but these are the results. And I don't want to go through them, but you will see that, for example, that Manhattan has nearly exactly the same result, but that bottom one is significantly faster on the M4 Pro. But I'm just leaving it for you to pause, and if you are interested and understand them, then maybe this will make sense for you. I simply wanted to include them in this video, but these are kind of the tests that I don't really understand. The next test, though, is the one that I understand very well, because this is something that I kind of invented. I just created a large 10 gigabyte text file, and then I timed the gzip command, which means we are compressing this 10 gigabyte file. And I thought 10 gigabytes will, you know, that it will take ages, but in fact, M1 Pro did it in just 39 seconds. I think it's quite impressive. But M4 Pro did it in 16 seconds, which is less than half of the time that it took for M1 Pro. But honestly, the fact that M1 Pro can compress 10 gigabytes of data in 39 seconds, I think even today it's still really great processor. And now it's the battery test. You can see we are fully charged. Both laptops have 100% of battery. I started the stopwatch. And what I have here is 4K video. I mean, I manually set it to 4K. Even though it's not full screen, it's manually set to 4K. And that's basically it. That's my test. We are running YouTube video in 4K. When I started doing it, though, I realized the time zone is not correct on the M4 laptop. No idea why. I'm pretty sure I set it correctly when I was setting it up. So this second video shows you that I amended it, because it was previously 10 a.m., but now it's 1800, because I did it in the evening, yesterday evening. That's something I just spotted randomly while checking that battery level. And now we've got a result after 56 minutes, close to an hour. We've got 89% for M1 processor, laptop with M1, and we've got 91% for the M4 Pro laptop. That's another test after 2 hours. So we've got 70% on the M1 Pro. And we've got 75% on M4 Pro. 2 hours, 25 minutes. Let's have a look. M1 Pro, 61% and 68%. For M4 Pro. And again, 45% on M1 Pro, and on M4 Pro we've got 53%. And this is after 3 hours, 3 hours 18 minutes. What I want to mention, though, remember that M1 Pro is a 3 years old laptop with battery health of 93%, which is quite good, to be honest. I didn't expect that. But it's still 93% and the laptop is 3 years old. What I mean, in my opinion, these batteries, I mean, how quickly they drain, I would say they are very close to each other. This old laptop is still doing quite fine. I mean, alright, it has 45% versus 53% on the new one. But if we take that 53% and multiply by 0.93, that's the half of the battery on M1 Pro, we will have 49. I mean, this 53% would be 49% if this battery had only 93% of health rather than 100% as it currently has. And the other thing, it was already close to 10 p.m. I went to bed, slept for a while, I woke up at 1 a.m., which was 3 hours later, and I realized They both switched off. Both laptops. When I connected them to the charger, they both showed around 5 hours 50 minutes, 6 hours. So yes, if you watch YouTube in 4K with brightness on a high, it will only, I mean, it's not only, but it's not 25 hours battery, it will become 6 hours battery, yes? But yes, these are all tests that I prepared for today. So I hope this material is helpful for you, and thank you for watching.